Welcome to Open Heaven's Devotional Commentary, a guide to a close fellowship with God with Salami Energy Harina, your host. We are glad to have you today.
Hello, good day, friends, and thank you for joining us today again. Open Heavens is written by our Father in the Lord, Pastor E.A. Adeboye, General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And this commentary is intended to bring insights to God's Word by the help of the Holy Spirit. Today's date is Tuesday, the 12th day of October 2021, and our topic for today is Victory Through Holiness. Let us pray. Our righteous Father, we thank you for the privilege of learning at your feet again. Thank you for your Word that comes to instruct and to guide us. We ask that as you speak, Lord, you cause our hearts to be receptive. Help us to be obedient to your instructions and help us to find life in them in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. You're welcome back. Our memory verse for today is from the book of Proverbs chapter 14 verse 34. Proverbs 14 verse 34 reads, "Righteousness exalteth a nation, but sin is a reproach to any people." Proverbs 14 verse 34. And our scripture reading for today is from the book of Daniel chapter 6 from verse 19 to 23. Daniel 6 verse 19 to 23 reads, "Then the king arose very early in the morning and went in haste unto the den of lions. And when he came to the den, he cried with a lamentable voice unto Daniel. And the king spake and said to Daniel, O Daniel, servant of the living God, is thy God, whom thou servest continually, able to deliver thee from the lions? Then said Daniel unto the king, O king, live forever. My God hath sent his angel, and hath shut the lions' mouth, that they have not hurt me, for as much as before him innocency was found in me, and also before thee, O king, have I done no hurt. Then was the king exceedingly glad for him, and commanded that they should take Daniel up out of the den. So Daniel was taken up out of the den, and no manner of hurt was found upon him, because he believed in his God." God bless his word in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. In the body of our devotional today, our Father in the Lord tells us that there is victory in holiness. When the eyes of a child of God are opened to this revelation, he or she would begin to live righteously. Today's memory verse presents a two-edged sword of the truth. While righteousness exalts a nation, sin or unrighteousness brings reproach that comes in the form of defeat to a people. In today's Bible reading, Daniel said, "My God had sent his angel, and had shut the lion's mouth, that they have not hurt me, for as much as before him innocency was found in me, and also before thee, O king, have I done no hurt." Here is victory in holy living, confirmed by the testimony of the prophet. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 1 verse 9, "Thou hast loved righteousness and hated iniquity. Therefore God, even thy God, had anointed thee with the oil of gladness above thy fellows. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but the word of God shall remain," according to our Lord Jesus Christ in Matthew chapter 24 verse 35. Some Christians claim that it is impossible to live holy. Like I always tell my children in the Redeemed Christian Church of God, the fact that you are not living holy does not mean it is impossible to do so. The Bible says in 1 John chapter 3 verse 7 to 8, "Little children, let no man deceive you. He that doeth righteousness is righteous, even as he is righteous. He that committeth sin is of the devil, for the devil sinneth from the beginning. For this purpose the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil." A person is either holy or sinful. There is no midpoint. No sinner will make it to heaven. For this reason, Jesus came to destroy the works of the devil in our lives. You are righteous by grace. This grace is what removes boasting, because it is not you, but Christ in you. This, however, does not make us deny that God helps people to live holy. Pray earnestly for the grace to live holy because of the blessings that come with it. Daniel triumphed over all his enemies. They perished in his place because of his life of holiness. I pray that the grace to live holy will come upon you today, and you will live every day in victory from now in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless His word to us today. Our topic today talks about victory through holiness. Holiness in our world today is considered a thing of the past. It is considered by many as a thing that is outdated. But that is not true. Holiness is still the way to go. Scripture tells us that without holiness, no man shall see the Lord. Hebrews 12 verse 14. God also tells us to be holy because He Himself is holy. So we can say as well that holiness is a command, not even an option. And if we must see God, then we must ensure that we live holy lives. Our memory verse for today makes it very clear that there are blessings attached to righteousness and holy living. Proverbs 14 verse 34 tells us that righteousness exalted a nation, but sin is a reproach to any people. If you want to be exalted, whether as a nation or as an individual, then righteousness must be enthroned. Sin, on the other hand, causes reproach. Reproach is not something to be desired. Reproach is unwanted. A reproach is avoided like a plague. No one wants to associate with a reproach. And this is what sin turns a man into. That would not be our portion in the name of Jesus. Our Bible reading for today is the story of Daniel when he was cast into the lion's den. I would like us to consider it. Verse 20 of Daniel chapter 6 reads, "And when he came to the den," that's talking about the king now, "he cried with a lamentable voice unto Daniel. And the king spake and said to Daniel, O Daniel, servant of the living God, is thy God, whom thou servest continually, able to deliver thee from the lions?" In other words, even the king knew that he was a righteous man, and it was expected that God would save him even for that reason alone. He said, "Is thy God, whom thou servest continually, able to deliver thee from the lions?" Now listen to Daniel's own response. Verse 21 reads, "Then said Daniel unto the king, O king, live forever. My God hath sent his angel, and hath shut the lion's mouth, that they have not hurt me. For as much as before him, innocency was found in me, and also before thee, O king, have I done no hurt." Now I want us to put emphasis on that place that says, "For as much as before him, innocency was found in me." The reason the lions were mute, the reason why the mouths of the lions were shut, was because innocency was found in him. In other words, he had lived a holy life and was not guilty of all the charges. The story was different for the men who had accused Daniel. After Daniel was taken out of that lion's den, the king commanded that all his accusers, together with their families, be thrown into the den. Scripture tells us that before they had even gotten to the bottom of the den, the lions had taken hold of them and broken all their bones in pieces. This is the destruction of those who are not innocent. Do not forget that our memory verse tells us sin is a reproach to any people. Another example, one that we are very familiar with in Scripture, is that of Joseph. When Potiphar's wife was requesting immorality from him, his response was, "How then can I do this great wickedness and sin against God?" He understood that it was sin, and he knew what the repercussion could be. Joseph may have gotten a few favors if he had succumbed, but that was nothing compared to the victory God was planning ahead for him. Joseph was eventually set over the land of Egypt, second in command only to Pharaoh himself. This also was victory through holiness. But before Pharaoh made him the one in charge, here was what Pharaoh said in Genesis chapter 41 verse 38. He said to his servants, "Can we find such a one as this is, a man in whom the Spirit of God is?" The Spirit of God was upon Joseph. This could have only been achieved through holiness. So today we have been admonished by our Father in the Lord. He says, a person is either holy or sinful. You cannot be in the middle, as there is no midpoint. As long as we are in this flesh, there would always be temptations. But is holy living possible? Yes, it is. We understand that God helps people to live holy. He grants us the grace, so our righteousness is by grace, not by strength alone. It is at this point that we will bow our heads and would pray, would say, "Father, please help me to live a life that is holy unto you in the mighty name of Jesus." Ask for that help intentionally, the grace to live holy. not by might, not by your rules and regulations, but by the Spirit of God, by His grace made available to us. Father, help us live lives that are holy, lives that bring glory to You. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Our gracious Father, we want to just appreciate You for all Your goodness and Your mercies. We cannot thank You enough. We ask today that You continue to strengthen us to live lives of righteousness and holiness, that in the end, all glory will be ascribed unto Your name. And help us that as we do so, we'd move from victory to victory. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. We want to thank You for joining us today again. We are glad that You are around, and we believe You have been blessed as well. If you'd love to speak to someone or to receive updates like this daily, please send a WhatsApp or Telegram message to +234 80 986 11 226. We'd be waiting to hear from you. You can also be the reason why others would be blessed by this. Please do well to share with them. As you go forth today, receive the grace to live holy in Jesus' name. Amen. Have a great day and bye for now.
I believe you enjoyed today's devotional. We'd love to hear from you. Kindly leave a comment. You can connect with us on any of our social media handles attached. God bless you. Have a great day and see you tomorrow.